second in the Brownlow.
There you go, second in the Brownlow, about 40, 40 metres.
Yeah, there you go. He'd be a good age.
Yeah.
Be 80 something, wouldn't he? Training every day when he lives in Caulfield or something. Doesn't have a car. I suppose when you get to that age, you're probably better off not driving anyway. It's the tram over, the tram home. Well, somebody drives him, I suppose. All clubs have got blokes like that, haven't they?
Yeah. They're there at about half past 12 or 1 o'clock.
Yeah.
Jumpers laid out and just waiting.
They take them home when they're torn, take their wife and stuff, sell them up.
About the North Melbourne side that I think they're gathering a bit of momentum. Wayne
Carey. It's just about due. This is his ninth game back from the shoulder injury. He's just about due to turn one on, and this environment could well be it.
Well, he's been playing a lot of games at centre-half back, so the versatility angle I think Denis Pagan is looking for, back line, forward line, and I think with the loss, Peter, of Corey McKernan, that's been a big blow, because North were looking at going into the final eight with a lot of form under their belt.
It's Corey McKernan, a big loss, so they are down in manpower. Hawthorn last week without Paul Salmon. The Hawks have made three changes, Hassel, Salmon and Trelevin coming into the side. Out of the lineup, Justin Crawford, Hay and Stevenson. Chris Langford on screen, today playing his 302nd senior game in his last AFL season. The Hawks a long run of outs, and they'll be hoping they can turn the corner here this afternoon.
And what a magnificent player Chris Langford has been, so his penultimate game could well be against Wayne Carey, there at centre-half back against the North Melbourne champion, but 4 day premierships, 4 night premierships, it's been a tremendous effort from Chris Langford. Paul Salmon returning to the side, that's a very, very important player coming back, a late withdrawal with a back injury last week, so he will be critical in the absence of Corey McKernan, and as Peter mentioned, Hassel and Trelevin, the other two players coming in, so there is a bit of experience coming back into the Hawthorn side there.
And there's Jason Dunstall, part of the match committee today for the Hawthorn side, with Peter Schwab in front on the left, Georgie Stone, the former Paran champion, and also former runner during the 80s when we won all those premierships, so a lot of, and John Kennedy Jr. on the far left, if we can just grab him as well, so Dunstall obviously looking for maybe a coaching position next year, Wheels. What do you think?
I suggest you don't do it, Jason. Keep away from it, mate.
So round 21, the penultimate AFL round, a vital game for North. Can Hawthorn break their drought? Just about set to start. North Melbourne's final team sheet said that Mark Roberts was playing, but he's not out there. Stuart Anderson, one of the emergencies, has taken his place. John Clatton, the acting Hawthorn captain, has won the toss, and the Hawks are going to the right in the first quarter. Torrential rain, one of the first wet Saturdays we've had of the year, one of the first wet footy days we've had of the year. Salmon and Longmire, Blakey's quick kick. Harford tries to paddle it wide. Gets taken out of the contest. Ooh. The North Melbourne players, just a few moments back, changed a lot of their shoes, taking off the moulders. Good
and,
move.
And Pete Wayne Carey has started at centre-half back on Jonathan Robberin.
So a bounce centre-half forward for North. Salmon over the top. Taylor couldn't get a kick away. Trelevin does. Kicks it up towards midfield. Carey fists the ball further Hawthorne's way. Platt, the rat at the bottom of the pack. Scott down there with him. It's pretty willing from both sides as Crawford goes in. Platton dragged off the footy by Stevens. And the umpire this time will bounce it at Hawthorne centre half forward position.
Bit of feeling here between the players. Wet, slippery conditions as Wayne Swash is wrapped up in a tackle by Aaron Lord, the true centre half forward position for the Hawthorne side. Very slippery. I think it might suit the North Melbourne, so they may be a bit stronger. Hawthorne have a lot of young players, maybe not as physically strong, but North hard at the ball, played a lot of night football when the ball is traditionally slippery and wet and being on the ground, so quite used to these conditions. As Carey gets a kick from centre-half back to the centre of the field. High big pack punches the ball now off the ground by Scholl. Desperate stuff by Crummell it was, also by Dixon for the Hawthorne team. Scott trying the desperate handball off the ground by Trelevin, who just come into the side, recovering from a hamstring. Off the ground, out of bounds on the fall. Free kick to Hawthorne. Trelevin plays on quickly, got a couple of teammates up the field in Scott. In turn, looking towards centre forward, but John Blakey, the North Melbourne side in defence, looking to play on. Umpire Dennis Rich calls play on. Blakey went to motion to handball. Off the hands again, slippery footy as we've mentioned. Simpson wrapped up by Crummell. Tapped on by the North Melbourne side. Babel meters Shane Crawford with courage. Running against the flow. Langford off the side of the boot. Towards the boundary line. We've seen a lot of this today. Richard Taylor, clever work. Slips over and pushes the ball 10 metres up the field out of bounds.
So you wonder about that kick, don't you? Yeah, whether it was a momentary lapse in concentration or it's indicative of the very slippery conditions. The rain has set in, very blustery and difficult conditions for the players.
And we both want to be out at the Whit Noble today, Terry. Wouldn't it be terrific out there?
Trelevin. I retract everything I said.
Taylor. Taylor's kick just past centre wing. Chick was the fire for Hawthorne. Carey from Pike. Allison, a clever knock-on to get it away from Scott. Went with a football we're not accustomed to. Archer couldn't handle it. Now Hawthorne through Woods. Dixon. Out it comes to Graham. Graham's kick up towards left half forward. Martin tries to punch. Chick grab. Didn't have the footy. Free kick.
Good play. Well, just the ability to be able to play it there out in front of himself. And Daniel Chick's been a real find, I think, for Hawthorne. Sitting number two on the goal kicking there behind Nick Holland, but the conditions are going to be difficult because it slips, it'll slide, and players just playing the ball out in front of themselves, just as Daniel Chick there did, have the real opportunity to buy a free kick.
Can you believe a Hawthorn player may win the goal kicking at Glen Ferry, kicking about 30 goals for the year? Hard to believe.
A long time since that's been done.
I think it was Johnny Peck or thereabouts. Might have been Terry Ingersoll going back into the 50s.
Terry Ingersoll.
Well, we'll get an idea of the wind and the rain. With this kick, he's kicked a goal. First blood to the Hawks.
Well, you're right, Pete. Johnny Peck in 1966 had 32 goals on the board.
That'll be about a winning score for the Hawks this year.
32 goals, 1966. John Peck in the last year, he kicked led the goal kicking by in 6 years in a row.
There's the free kick, then the kick for goal.
Good start for the Hawks. First major on the board. First score, Daniel Chick from a free kick about 25, 30 metres out on a slight angle, and the Hawthorn side played it well. Good system up through the centre of the ground. Paul Salmon this time, big long handball wide, finding Brad Scott for Hawthorn on the left foot. Deep into the 50, they high flies with Nick Holland. Martin punches it away, Lord.
the toss of the coin, John Platten elected to kick to the right of screen, and the flags on top of the scoreboard are blowing violently towards the left of screen. So the conditions at high up in the air are against Hawthorn at the moment, but down at ground level they're making the most of the opportunity.
Ball is punched clear down to the ground now. It's Stevens, prolific ball winner for the North Melbourne side, leading in all those possessions. Long kick up towards centre forward, a free kick paid to North Melbourne's Chris Groome for too high. Umpire Brett Allen called it.
So Groome's at centre half forward on Lawrence with Carey at centre half back.
Short pass to Allison, gains 15 metres. Allison will now shoot from 45, slight angle. And as Terry mentioned, it seems at the top of the scoreboard that the flags are blowing towards the North Melbourne end, but there's a swirling wind here at the MCG. It can be very deceiving, so it could be favouring Hawthorn at ground level. So it's the only reason I can understand John Platten chose to kick to the right of the screen.
Certainly amazed us up here, didn't it?
Allison's kick carries pretty well, gets the distance easily enough. It looks pretty good. Their first goal.
So a goal apiece, free kick helping North, the unguarded Allison taking the mark, and the Roos get to within a point.
So a good quick reply, where Hawthorn really had control of the ball just in these opening 5 minutes, and North Melbourne in their first push forward are rewarded by Allison getting on the end of it, and the left foot. He'll have a very tough duel here. Brad Scott's his direct opponent for the afternoon.
North Melbourne won the reserves here today, 17-11, 113 to 8-7-55, or over at Punt Road, I should say. Up to the Hawthorn left half forward flank, Martin charges out from defence. Onto Laidley, playing his 150th, straight into the arms of Harford at left centre wing. And Hawks' most courageous player award last year, Robren. And he takes the boundary umpire with him. The rat, he looks like a drowned rat today.
Just got the advantage at the moment in the matchups, in that North Melbourne are looking at the two players running at the moment with Harford. Harford wants Stevens, but Simpson wants Harford. That allows a Hawk player free.
Oh, Platten's kick, not bad. You have to wait on the goal umpire. I think he's kicked it. He has. It's a goal. Oh, great kick.
What a great kick. Under these conditions, on the boundary line, excellent stuff. But what's impressed me the most, Terry, is that the Hawthorn players are finding space in that ever reliable defence in North Melbourne.
Yeah, it's just revolving just for a moment around that Harford-Stevens-Simpson thing, that there will always be a Hawthorn player who, with a little bit extra work, will be able to create the space. Platten's being picked up by Robert Scott, but just found the change there and the ability to be able to sneak off, find room on that outer half-forward flank.
Well, the Hawks have their second on the board thanks to Johnny Platten. Daniel Chick has their first, and Brett Allison, the sole goal kicker for North, as Salmon gets the tap down straight to Shane Crawford, and he's tackled well by Anthony Stevens. Stevens also leading the tackles for North Melbourne in the wash-up of the AFL, leading the possessions, so must be pretty close to favourite for their best and fairest award this year. He's had an excellent season. Again, the kick out of the centre, ever reliable Stevens. Poor bounce from Mellington, allowing Langford, his kick, gaining a bit more distance than his first one, slipping off the side of the boot. Shane Crawford, clever work, outrunning Blakey. Now Daniel Harford from half-back, looking for the leading Robren. Well punched clear by Wayne Carey. Surprising me, it's in half-back. He's the best in half-forward in the business. That's right, playing, but obviously Denis Pagan has his own reasons. Now Scott, the chess mark, handballing off to Shane Crawford, who's been busy on left centre wing, looking for Holland behind. Forced to punch, Pike under pressure. Good handle, good vision to Schwoss. Equally good vision to David King, to Wayne Carey at centre-half-back.
Carey to half-forward. Overhead marks hard to take today. Hawthorn with the numbers. Ball socket off the ground towards Hawthorne's right half-forward flank. Lord and Schwoss. Good tackle. Schwoss not rewarded for it, though, by the umpire.
Someone down here, Pages, on the left, if we can...
On the Coca-Cola emblem, just to the left of that. North Melbourne player on his haunches.
Oh, nice wind. David King.
Kick in the meantime comes up towards the 50-metre line for the Hawks. Again with numbers. Woods. Couldn't get the kick in time. Bell tried for the boundary line. Stevens and Lekas underneath. Lekas has to paddle it wide. Picked up by Bell. He's dispossessed just as quickly. Tackled by Trelevin. Platten couldn't get clear. Stevens has got him. And the umpire will ball it up.
King's not too good, Pete.
He just just gets cleaned up in this second piece of action here. He comes in again here now, and just the work off the ball. Nothing untowards there between the clash between Crummell and King, but he's certainly wearing it.
Platten, 3 second. Good hand pass by Robren. Chick pressuring Scott. Tried for the boundary line, didn't get there. Lord will take it over, though, under pressure. And it will be thrown in Hawthorn's right forward pocket.
Terry, just as much as the players have to adjust to these conditions, what about the umpires as far as...
Oh, without doubt. I mean, in normal conditions, I think there's a little bit of assumption. Yes, he's going to mark this ball and the umpire's ready to play. Here, he can't make those assumptions.
Longmire, Robren, Lord, Platten over his shoulder. Not the required distance. Robren, clever. Didn't find a teammate, though. Longmire. North able to get clear. Kick comes from Simpson up towards the 50-metre line. Anderson was there, late enclosed on the side. Kick up to midfield. Crummell over the top. Scholl, both players can play it full forward. Millington, Langford off the ground, and that's the way to play wet weather football, fellas. And Lawrence, good pick-up by the big fellow at left centre wing.
Plenty of time to handle over to Brad Scott, has been one of the Hawks' best defenders so far. Oh,
great work, Langford, great work.
As Terry mentioned, Langford's run from the back pocket right up to the centre wing to support his teammates. Poland's pushed out of the ball by the stronger Mick Martin. And Mickey Martin showing great skills, dry weather skills, taking a two-grab mark.
But just for Chris Langford to stay in the contest all the way from that initial kick off the ground, supporting his players right up to the outer wing.
The Martin drop punt. Grooms pushed in the back, Blakey in front of the pack. One of the North Melbourne's team rules, you've got to get square on. Craig Scholl off the ground, this is clever work from North. Trying to push the ball forward, Mellington over the top now to the running Groom, just in time. In front is Harvey, clever work, not falling over. Stewie Anderson, late inclusion, round the corner, towards the forward pocket, but way too far. The wind has carried it over the line, out of bounds. Crowd not too happy about something that's happened, a bit of a decision. In these conditions, it could be either way. It's Brad Scott again. His fourth kick, seventh possession. Crummell to Mark Graham. To the running Taylor. This is good play by the Hawks in these conditions. Well led and well marked by Daniel Chick. He's kicked their first goal. He's in the centre of the ground. He's got Aaron Lord all on his own. Interfered with.
Bell coming back with the flight of the ball there, Russ.
But I think he had to do something. Put his hand up and just clipped Lord over the top of the face. So Lord will take the free kick in 50.
Somewhat exaggerated, do you think?
Oh, well, yeah, I suppose. You know, you've got to play for it. Lord's kick is wide towards the pocket. The big punch from Mickey Martin. No other alternative, Mick. Fist straight into the leather and gains 25 metres over the line.
Doesn't he take control there? We saw earlier he's playing his 197th game of football. He's played the last 50 consecutively. His last miss was in late 1995.
And twice best and fairest too.
Sensational.
Back, so that's a great effort. Robren over the top of Carey, bringing it back into the corridor. Chick off the ground. This will test you, Mick. He's in front off the ground. Great stuff from the North Melbourne fullback. Now to 11 under the hammer. Caught. North Melbourne supporters claiming Crummell off the ground. Now King's back on, he's recovered, the ribs are okay. Straight at the ball like a steam train. Off the ground, David King. Great stuff, North Melbourne halfback. Archers met solidly. This is great stuff, hard, tough stuff in the wet. Mark Graham kicks wide. Daniel Chick running, can he beat the ball over the line?
He can't, the ball beats them all. Aaron Lord and Wayne Schwartz throw in.
I'm not sure whether there's much value with Wayne Carey at centre-half-back in this sort of game, because the flow of the ball up into the Hawthorn forward line is going to be quite unpredictable in these wet and slippery conditions. So there's not going to be chances for Wayne Carey to judge the ball and take a good mark. I think perhaps he now needs to move back to centre-half forward.
The fish and the horse contested the throw-in. Samet and Longmire. Simpson off the ground. Archer. Back into the North Melbourne side today. A welcome re-inclusion, the Norman Smith medalist. So throw it on centre wing. You'd reckon probably 10 goals would be a winning score here today. Salmon with Longmire. Longmire gets front posse. Salmon too tall. Not an effective knockout. Stevens off the ground. Graham. Now Pike's taken the mark. Might be downfield. Yep. Or is it coming back?
Archer just a little bit aggressive after the ball was kicked there by Mark Graham, his direct opponent. Hit it again. each other. Here it is. There's the kick, and there's the woof into the midriff.
So Chick with the free kick for Hawthorn. This one won't be a goal. He's kicked one already. Not a bad roost, though. So that breeze is deceptive. Robert at the back. Laidley, the junkyard dog, rushes it through for one behind. Anything today, I think, would be acceptable.
Yeah, great return, Dean Laidley, back into the side after a thigh injury and a couple of weeks in the reserves to get going. His 150th game of AFL football, 98 for North Melbourne after 52 with the West Coast Eagles.
Schwoss, Carey underneath it, gets a second chance, tries to paddle it forward for a teammate towards the wing, that's King. Longmire provides the shepherd. King's kicked a half forward, Langford doesn't try to mark it under the conditions. Chance for the ruse, Harvey, Scholl, well shepherded, then well caught by Crummell. Flipped up, Groom, Groom goes at goal. That looks pretty good, he's kicked a goal. Oh, he's hit the post, he's hit the post. I don't think he saw that. And his third AFL club has had knee reconstructions. 2-2 to 1-1, the Hawks by 7 points, 8.5 minutes left in a very wet first quarter.
Graham, the kick out, landing in Scott's arms. As we said, he's been very busy in the back pocket. We can hear the Hawk mascot in the background. It sounds a bit much like the Western Bulldogs, woof woof. We've got the Hawk in the background near one of the effects microphones, cheering for their side. If Richard Taylor's wrapped up by Glenn Archer, umpire Dennis Rich says, give it to me, I'll bounce it, but if it's too wet, I'll throw it up. Up it goes, Salmon, big left hand, hooks it into the pocket. Harvey trying to poke for a free kick. Umpire Dennis Rich says, no. Play on's the call, and I'll have another throw up. Left half back for the Hawthorn side.
Hawthorn have a clear advantage with Salmon in doing the ruck work here against Groom.
Well, over 200 games more experience as Craig Scholl lines up for his first. Off the side of the boot, or maybe straightened up a bit too much and pushed it to the right as Stephen Lawrence is being replaced, coming off the ground. These sort of conditions not really suiting him, with Darren Kepler coming on.
That's so a surprise. I mean, Kepler's first quarter last week with some 11 kicks. He was quite dominant and starts this week on the interchange bench.
Well, some coaches have their own reasons. It's the Graham kick finding the leading Platten, gaining 30 metres. Hawks doing this well so far. Just 7 minutes remaining in this first term as Platten's kicks wide towards right centre wing. Aaron Lord held. Nearly took a one-hander. Richard Taylor in front of the pack. His kick around the shoulder. Wayne Schwoss unable to mark the wet slippery ball. Has time to spin around on the left boot. The high flyer is Scott in front of Platten.
Trelevin was being held.
Umpire Allen calls it. So does Pete Landy. Good decision. As Trelevin offloads to Taylor off half back. He kicks long. Long in these conditions, about 40 metres, as Adam Simpson takes a good mark on centre wing for the Kangaroos.
In front of his skipper too. Simpson short of the centre wing. Atrocious conditions at the moment. North with the numbers, and it's a North mark. Groom, that'll give him some confidence.
He's making a good fist of this centre-half forward role in the opening part of this game.
Salmon backing back, tried to take it overhead, couldn't do so. And the ball out of bounds. Stevens tried to go off the ground, that Danny Stevens. It'll be thrown in next to the behind post.
I suppose, Terry, that's as good a reason not to move Carey to centre-half forward.
Well, yeah, I mean, if Denis Pagan is looking to see if he can develop depth within his side going into the finals, giving Groom experience, he should do it.
Oh, Longmire gets rid of Salmon. He can't get rid of the boundary umpire because he's going to throw it in. In fact, it's out of bounds on the floor.
There is a difficulty for coaches at this time of year. That are they coaching for the finals? Are they coaching for the last two games? I think Denis Pagan in this game is coaching for finals.
Platten in front, couldn't complete it. Simpson, grab, still got a kick in. That was terrific stuff. Allison, always dangerous, close to goal. Offloads with a hand pass. And the kick came from Danny Stevens, but he's missed and put it through for one behind.
Well, he's one of the young players, obviously, in round 21, wanting to establish himself in the side as they approach the finals.
And the Hawks making another change. Johnny Hassel is coming on.
North have settled after the early onslaught from Hawthorn.
And there's Hassel, the player just on, and he got that just inside the boundary line in the right back pocket.
So that's
that's the best way you want to start, coming on the field and getting a first touch. It just gives you added confidence, brings you into the game a lot quicker than usual. As Shane Corbett running away from the flight of the ball, hit him on the back of the head and was deemed interference on John Blakey. So he will take the subsequent free kick. Left half forward, long kick from John Blakey with this big breeze into the goal square. Langford, under pressure, paddles it through for a rush behind. So four straight behinds for the North Melbourne side over the top of that initial goal from Allison. Hawks 2-2. Now they lead by 4 points. Very wet conditions here at the G. 5 minutes remaining in the first term. North need to win. They're coming off a loss against Richmond by a point as Stevens tries the big punch. It slips off his fist as Harford tumbles it forward about 25 metres. Scott does well. Handball to Lord. He gets a quick kick. Martin Pike running with the flight of the ball in front of Daniel Chick. Takes a good defender's mark. Change of direction is the key for North Melbourne. He's got the running Carey. Let's have a look at your mate up Carey out at centre back. Fantastic stuff, Duck. And a beautiful pass. That is class. Off the half back line for North Melbourne. What an excellent effort from Wayne Carey. We questioned him being a centre back. He's done nothing wrong so far today. And that was one of the plays of the day under these conditions. Stevens from 50. His kick will land right in the goal square. The big punch is required from Salmon. But good defensive work from Johnny Hassel. Again, another rush behind for the North Melbourne side.
So the difference is back to 3 points now in the last 4 minutes of the quarter. Johnny Hassel, the former Magpie. 6 effective scoring shots to the ruse for just 1 goal on the board. Richard Taylor, short of half-back. No one standing the mark, so the Hawk Rover transfers play up towards centre wing. Should be a mark up there to Dixon. Under these conditions, I think it's a fair decision to play.
I think it's a very good mark. This boy has really shown some talent on the left foot. 3 goals a couple of times already this year.
He's gone the long way home, which under these conditions may not have been the right option. Looking for Robren. It's 1-5 to 2-2 at the MCG. Our first rainy Saturday in a long, long time. The farmers will be appreciating the rain. And I dare say the groundsman would too if a game of footy wasn't being played here at the moment. Salmon had to reach over the top, gets it back. Couldn't get it to Platten. Pike's in there. Stevens likewise dives on it. The umpire again will ball it up.
Pete Russell mentioned before North Melbourne coming off a surprise loss last week, but Hawthorn, they lost the last 6 in a row or something. They've got a lot to play for, and I think this will be a real scrap every step of the way here this afternoon.
Well, they won't toss it in. Platten's kick up to half four. That's as far as it's going. Carey in the road. Lord chases. No one on the mark. The Ducks kick up to half forward. Groom was the target. Couldn't complete it. Scholl. A little give to Archer. Archer's short pass intended for Harvey. Allison loves these. 25 metres out but misses and puts it through for only one behind.
We just saw an example there of the value of Glenn Archer in that he decided not to go into the marking contest where he is very, very competent in the air but roved the ball and was able to turn it back in North Melbourne's way, set up the Allison opportunity.
1-6-2-2. Kepler, like Johnny Hassel, getting his first touch coming off the bench and the mark taken by Paul Salmon at right half-back. He'll kick to centre wing.
Looking for John Platten. Platten punches it forward, gaining valuable metres, but they meet head-on. Is that Robren? And his opponent is Dean Lely. 150 games to Dean Lely. Congratulations to him. Playing in his 11th season. First out in 1987. So a great effort. Playing for West Coast and also North Melbourne. Robren punch. Pushes Hawthorn forward, Dixon close to the line. Very difficult, slippery conditions. 2.5 minutes remaining in the first term. It's the Hawks by 2 points. North Melbourne have had most of the play the last 10 or so minutes, kicking 1-6. A lot of those rush, but still, if Tony Woods now on the 50, if he can pick it up, he does. But his handball is wayward, intercepted by Schwoss, who's under pressure. The Carey handball looking for Bell, finds him. Now the North side can steady with John Blakey's kick out of half-back. Salmon, clever work with the right hand. Second effort, trying to find Longmire.
Hawthorn player down with a cut forward. He had a clash with Wayne Schwoss, who's also in the hands of the trainers.
And David King through the centre of the ground. Now kicks wide. And wayward, landing on the chest of Johnny Hassel. So Pete, keep us in touch. Oh, there's Aaron Lord with a nice old cut on the forehead.
He was the player concerned.
He'll be going off to be stitched up as Shane Crawford delivers wide to Scott. takes his time trying to size up the situation up forward. Rodman can't mark. Good defensive work from Carey. Be a defender's day today with these conditions. It's hard, but the ball slips right through his hands. Now Scholl, back to Carey. Tumbles it forward. Could bounce through, but across the face of goals and out of bounds. In the left back pocket, adjacent. There's Lord, who's still wondering.
This is an interesting ruling here. Here's the clash of heads. Schwast and Lord there. But the umpires, they're just too dash slow in picking that up.
Should have held the play.
Yeah, they should. Now, Lord had every right not to leave the ground unless directed to by the umpire.
Now, even so, that's a good point, Terry, because David King was running up the field.
Lord should not leave the ground. He can't leave the ground, Lord, I don't think, and leave his side man short.
No.
Under the rules of the game, the umpire, and it was umpire Vince Cercio who was the closest, he should be just keeping an eye on what's going on around him. He would have identified that, stopped the game so that there would be no disadvantage to the Hawthorn team as he left the ground.
Would they have stopped the game even when David King was running through centre wing here? Would they have just stopped
it? As soon as he sees that there is a blooded player on the field, stop the game.
Fair enough. There's a throw-in next to the North Melbourne point post. Crummell, desperate kick across the face of goal. Still under pressure. Allison, who's clever, keeps his feet. He's held by Scott. Harvey's the same. The North Melbourne supporters call him for holding the man. As Brett Allison, just the look on his face says it all.
Certainly playing for the free kick, Brett Allison.
He did it well in these conditions, Pete. That's what it's all about. It's too slippery to pick up. Just paddle it in front of you.
Salmon will gain some 30 metres with that punch. Half it will probably go off the ground. He does. He gets another 10. And so the throw-in is close to centre wing on the outer side. The clock ticking down to quarter time. Just over 1 minute remaining in the term.
So, Pete, we just see there how the matchups have settled. Is that Half it and Simpson have settled their differences and come together. Catlin now has Stevens, Bell and Woods in the midfield, and Scott and Platten.
Salmon with Longmire, Kepler. Little left toe poke. Stevens, Scott, runs into a brick wall. Too high, though, according to the umpire. One for the crowd out there. The North Melbourne fans baying for blood, and they've got
Aaron Lords.
Scott's kick to half forward. Good tackle by Archer. Crummell couldn't pick up the greasy ball. Langford trying to struggle forward with it. Bit of feeling out there. Don't think that'll worry.
You don't want to take Langers on. He's a very, very strong man. I saw Mark Jackson land about five or six good ones on that big chin of his, and he didn't even flinch.
Now, Dennis Rich is indicating it's a free kick to North Melbourne. And Craig Scholl has got it. Says, thanks very much. It's a good kick. North Melbourne mark.
That's a great kick, right into the square, really
Stevens.
Putting pressure on them.
Well, they got their first goal from a free kick after it was booted to Addison. And that one, a free kick. The mark has been taken this time by Danny Stevens. He would have to fall over to miss it. So a goal here would put North Melbourne in front, right on the siren or after the siren.
Thank you.
start the second quarter with Hawthorn leading by 1 point. Incredible miss by Danny Stevens right on the siren. Harford, Rain Hazee is just a little bit. Harford, the Platten, and the Rat quickly up towards half forward. Terrible kick though, under the conditions. We can make excuses for that. Pike, best and fairest at Fitzroy last year. Stevens off the ground. Clever. King, who was met heavily in the first quarter, trying to bounce it today. A super optimist. Graham. Archer takes the ball out of bounds on centre wing.
Just saw big Stephen Lawrence attack the ball, playing in the forward pocket for Hawthorn. Conditions difficult for the taller players, and Craig Trelevin, who's on the interchange bench, you'd suspect there may be an injury there, because I think he'd perhaps be better suited than Lawrence in that pocket.
Under these conditions, certainly. King around the outstretched arms of Kapler, and fist away there. For the Hawks, down in the back pocket by Angelo Lekas. It clears the line, throw it in North Melbourne's forward pocket.
It's Trelevin there with the dressing gown on, Pete.
Yeah, and big Randall Bone preparing to come on. Salmon leading in the hitouts and leading well. Kick up in the air by Danny Stevens, won't quite make the distance. Salmon again fists successfully towards the boundary line. Right next to Brett Addison, the throw-in adjacent to the behind post. Only a couple of metres from the scoring post.
So Lawrence has come off, but Randall Bone, the player, going there. Bone going right now to the full forward square and bringing out the more mobile Nick Holland to centre-half forward.
Graham relieving the pressure for the Hawthorn side with a big long kick outside 50 through left half-back. Blakey being harassed by Shane Crawford. Doing it well, not giving away a free kick. Very important under those circumstances. He could have easily just scragged him and dragged him to the ground. But sized up the option, and Daniel Chick lent his assistance. A few of the players have changed their jumpers. Wayne Schwoss now sporting a long sleeve. Stevens kick into the pack, off the ground by Allison.
And so with Holland coming out to centre-half forward, Wayne Carey has taken him, allowed Mickey Martin to go back on Rotherham. So two of the great marks playing football today pitted to one another in what will be very difficult conditions, though.
Well, Hawthorn have missed Nick Holland, and they still do, because he hasn't touched the ball so far in this game. We've played one quarter, whereas on the other hand, Wayne Carey has done reasonably well with six possessions with one mark at centre-half back. Longmire with the knockout. Not much gained underneath the pack. They pile on top of each other.
Now, Russell, when there's so many one-on-one matchups as there are in this particular game, any loose ball, really, it's going to be dived upon very quickly, and I think we'll see a lot of this from umpire Dennis Rich and his cohorts today, throwing the ball up.
Quick kick to Harford. Up towards centre wing now, David King, pursued by Chick. Excellent tackle. Platten plays it well. Handballs to himself, maybe trying to draw a free kick with the opponent close on his tail. But the North Melbourne players, much too clever for the Rat. Throw in, centre wing. 17 and a half minutes remaining in this second term. They've only just started, no addition to any score. It's Hawthorn by 1 point. It's off the ground by Graham. It'll go wide, and it'll be chest marked by Robert Scott on Hawthorn side of centre wing.
The former Cat from the boundary line. Ball still very slippery after the rain we had in the first quarter. Now the kick comes down. Harvey, kick off the ground, is near the 10-metre square. Scott takes it over, and it'll be another throw-in. So North Melbourne with all the play. Johnny Blakey there on screen.
That's a very good matchup, I think, from Denis Pagan. Crawford's been in very good form, and Blakey, one of the better negators in the game.
And one of the most experienced. Groom in front of Langford. Ryan tries to go off the ground. Hand pass to Scott from Shaw. Shaw gets it back again. Kick smothered by Graham. Ball flipped out to Archer. Archer has a snap at goal. One-on-one contest in the goal square, and it races through for one behind. Kicked by the Norm Smith medalist of last year, Glenn Archer, back into the side today. So that levels the scores. 1-8 to 2-2. 17 minutes left in the second term. We're not quite as strong as it was when the match got underway. Just a few spots of rain now, but conditions very slippery. Sam, hard to take.
Oh, well done.
Flips it out. attack for the first time in the quarter, really. Carey's kick. And the travel's about 40 metres. Langford couldn't complete the mark. Chick again, grabbed by Stevens. Hand pass comes back to Langford, who goes off the ground. Ineffective, as it turns out. Pike with the clearing kick.
Just kicked it straight onto the chest of Pike, only 2 or 3 metres away. And his long kick up towards centre wing, favouring Harvey, who's driven into the ground. They pile on top of each other again in these conditions. It's very wet, slippery. And the ball, we will see, probably spent 90% of its time on the ground as Aaron Lloyd has made his way back underneath the interchange gates, sporting a nice old steri strip on his forehead. Blood pouring out of his head with a clash from the back of Wayne Schwash's head as Langford, under more pressure than maybe he thought, under less pressure than he thought, and he had to hurry the kick. He made a meal of it as Taylor, off half-back now, with support from Lekas. Two young players were all on side. Holland had a chance to get his first possession as Carey deliberately kicks the ball off the ground, but very subtly drives it towards the back.
Yes.
He had a look back just the same.
But he's doing very well, Wayne Carey, playing a centre back on Nick Holland. 8 kicks, 1 handball and 1 mark. Holland gets his first touch, albeit being a hit out, but that's all part of it. Shane Crawford showing a bit of frustration there, being held very closely by John Blakey. As Terry Wheeler mentioned, a very good matchup, Tom. John Blakey approaching 250 games. That's an exceptional effort from him. Now Holland in front of Carey. Carey getting the push, keeping his feet, does well to Stevens. Quick kick, spoiled from behind. Now King, the speedster, up half back. Poor bounce. Now Mark Graham a chance. Blakey off the ground, right across the front. Here's a chance for Paul Salmon. If he can steady on the left boot, he can't steady all that well. Right across the face. And it wobbles over for a behind.
Well, North Melbourne fans believing that Allison should have got a free kick for kicking in danger. The umpire called play on. So Simmons behind makes the difference, 1 point in favour of Hawthorn again. I said earlier that 10 goals would probably be a winning score here today, and we've seen nothing to make us change our minds on that score. Crawford went for the specky, zips it out the back. Robins on the end of it. Came from Crummell, now Platt. Oh. The rat in everything today, kick number 6. A little bit too wide of Dixon in the forward pocket, and that's out of bounds for throwing. Not too much scoring, as I said. North Melbourne in the first quarter of 6 minutes. Stevens missing a sitter, Danny Stevens, that was, on the siren. And the Hawks at the 7 minute mark of the quarter, and of course the rain then set in. Lord back onto the ground and back into it almost.
This is where I'd nearly have Paul Salmon come down to do the ruck work.
Simpson with the clearing kick to the boundary line. King will see it over in front of Taylor, and it will be thrown in right on 50.
Pete, when goals are just so hard to come by, I think these boundary throw-ins and ball-ups within 30, 35 metres of goal are certain scoring opportunities, and I'd be putting my number one ruckman in to take them, and Nick Holland perhaps can drop out to build the defensive wall.
Longmire with Salmon, Pike in front. Ball underneath the Hawthorn player down there, but it's not holding the ball. There's Tony Woods. He's an accomplished keyboard player. Among his many talents, Longmire. Kapler. Carey. A quick kick. That gets it out of the danger zone to centre wing. Maybe not for long.
Mark Graham now hooks it round on the left foot. Salmon. Desperate handball. But the North Melbourne defence, all too strong and quick, as David King throws the ball onto the grass, trying to bounce it back. Makes a little bit of a fool of himself. Maybe he should try and touch it onto the wet grass, but umpire Dennis Rich finds a free kick going to Mark Graham.
He's the only player, Fly, who have tried to bounce it. Yeah. He's tried it twice.
Well, the first time worked, but the second one made a mill of it. Langford's wide. Now he kicks even wider, looking for the Daniel
Chick
lead.
Very good kick. Very good.
Ace out it was. Kicking. Chick has a lead into the pocket, but it's by the wrong colours. Wayne Carey, the captain of North Melbourne, premiership captain.
I tell you, he's the only second quarter, giving themselves opportunities.
Excellent mark from John Blakely, putting his body in the front of Tony Woods and taking the ball on his chest. Long kick up towards centre wing. Good body work from Chandler, but equally as good spoil by the veteran Chris Langford. 302 games today, flies down from Sydney each week to play. And probably one of the only guys that could get away with that, with the physique and the build he has, just a natural athlete. But has had hamstring troubles in the past. Blakey's kick straight on the chest of Langford, and the umpire deems that he'll pay that one because it slipped off his chest, but in these conditions will deem that as a mark.
And to think that man played the wing so very, very well in the early part of his career.
His first year in 1983, he played 11 games on the wing wheels.
Sensational.
As Simpson does well, keeps it in. It slips through his grasp and beats him over the line. Out of bounds in between centre wing and half forward for the Hawthorn side.
Dick played the same thing, didn't he? For Richmond, he started on the wing.
Yes,
end up at fullback. Mm. 12 minutes remaining in the half. It's Hawthorn by a point.
Holland tried it over the top. Bone. Well done, Randall. Bombs it long. Unfortunately, just to the left, it beats Martin and Pike. Over the boundary line for a throw in Hawthorn's left forward pocket.
Well, just kicking the ball into the forward line there. I think players need to concentrate on really just getting the ball to spin properly. You know, cut a little bit off the distance, pull it in by another 5 metres, but just ensure that the drop punt spins effectively so your teammate has an opportunity to mark it.
Martin, over the top, Harford, centres it, looking for some height in the goal square. Chick. That might be a North Melbourne free kick, no. Woods gives it to Kepler, who is the offender. Kepler snaps it goal and has put it through for the Hawks.
That's a good build-up. They've been trying really hard, Terry, in that forward line. They've kept it in there. North Melbourne have tried to run it out. They haven't got past the centre wing. Langford's been very good across half-back, and they've persevered and persevered, and it's paid off with a goal to Kepler.
Yeah, they've stayed disciplined as well. Here's Chick, you know, doing the right thing, tossing it back towards the top of the goal square. Woods there working with Kepler, creating an opportunity for the left footer. So if you can just stay disciplined in the team rules and the things you need to attend to in these conditions, you will get opportunities.
Well, the Kepler goal has just spurred on the rain to come down again as Bone is in the centre of the ground. He gets a 10-metre knockout. It's been a good one. Good hit back. It's been a volleyball. Wet with a volleyball from Shane Crawford. Robert Scott kicks it high, 30 metres back to the centre of the ground. Now a chance for Simpson. Tries the traditional blind turn. Gets away with it. Gets a good kick up towards centre half forward. Off the ground from the North Melbourne side. Now they're running. Good interception. That was from Johnny Hassel. It's a slippery ball. Kepler off the ground. That's the answer. Back to Simpson. Left foot. Man in front will win. Push in the back, according to umpire Cercia. Free kick will go to Lekas. Off to Mark Graham. He's been good. Wearing the number 34. Famous for the John Kennedy Jr. down at Hawthorn. Played over 250 games wearing that 34. Out of Kepler. Desperate stuff. Now Stevens has been quiet in this quarter. Had a lot of the ball in the first term and he's wrapped up. It's his 9 possessions, but I think most of those were in the first quarter.
Well, North Melbourne, really, they'd be a little bit anxious just at the moment, I would think. Hawthorn have come out to the second quarter and maintained some momentum. Picked up the only goal, but are winning a lot of the contests in close.
Longmire's hit out was punched forward, but only to be repelled by the Hawthorn defence.
Good
tackle
work again.
Schloss. That was by Richard Taylor. He does very well in that tackle department for a small man. Langford in the centre of the ground. Being a thorn in the side for North Melbourne today. All experience and strength. Long kicking. Salmon in front. Should be a free kick. It's called play on, according to umpire Dennis Rich. At least they're consistent. Now King under the hammer of Chick. He's caught on the line. He drags it over the line. It'll be a throw in.
Is that the prior opportunity or don't we see that anymore?
But he wasn't helped, but he did slip over the line prior to being tackled. So in all fairness, good decision, out of bounds in Hawthorn's forward line.
King being met solidly in the first quarter, left the field. He's come back as we would expect from him. Tough Port boy. Schwanner's kick is a little bit off target, but like one Chris Langford did from the same spot in the first quarter. Right off the side of the boot. Schwoss wearing the long sleeve jersey now. He started in the shorter one. I'd be surprised if a few more players followed suit in the second half. Salmon in front. He's had a good day, but misdirects that one. Bell's on the end of it. And that rain getting heavier again. Chandler back to Pike, the two former Fitzroy players, or two of them. Harvey couldn't handle it. Now Holland, his first kick. Straight to the opposition, snapped up by Chandler, marking in front of Lord.
Just disappointed at the moment with Hawthorne's work at these boundary throw-ins in the forward pocket. Last two, Salmon has got the ball back over the back, but there's been no Hawthorne player to take it.
Holland got the front position, couldn't drag it down. Good tackle by Simpson. Harvey goes off the ground. He's kicked it out of bounds on the full, though. Free kick to Hawthorn, and the recipient is going to be Crawford. They had Justin Knott in the side today. Shane's kick, terrible. Simpson. A little gift to Pike. Pike had left half back for the Ruse, up towards midfield. Well directed. Longmire had the sit there, but did well to get the footy in the end. King. King's kick to half forward. Archer puts it up high. Laidley on the end of it. He'd love to kick a goal in his 150th. That won't be a score out in front of goal square. Scott and Platten. Anthony Stevens. Off a step. Dixon nearly. Scott. Goes for the boundary line. Won't quite make it out there. Chick right on the boundary line. Gets the Hawks out of trouble.
Chick not too sure where to put it because he doesn't have any teammates up the field. Nick Holland now at last creates an option for him.
That was the best option he could to get over the boundary line,
yeah,
wasn't it?
He did have a bit of time lucky because David King was just sitting there waiting for the kick to land on his chest, but Chick had two alternatives. One, to hold the ball or to look for the boundary. And I think he picked the right one. Holland provided that option. Throw in. Right on centre wing. Good tap down from Longmire. Driven forward by Simpson. Man in front is Scholl. That's where you've got to be in these conditions. Now Scott, number 8 for North Melbourne, has the leading Allison. Kind bounce, took his eye off it also briefly. Now has time to spin around. All too easy on his left foot and could put his second through. But Archer will take it right in the goal square. Maybe should have let it go, but in those circumstances, wasn't maybe aware where the goals were, so he probably did the right thing. Make sure of it. North Melbourne second.
And might have a few words to him later on.
No, he had a bit of a smile on his face. I think if we have a chance to have a look at it again, you might see Archer was running with the flight of the ball, not too sure where the goals were, so really he did have to mark it.
Of course, they moved the goals last week, so maybe that was the reason for his doubt.
But the Hawthorn defence here, they just lose it there a little bit. I mean, Allison was always going to come back. That's his real trademark, that being able to gather the ball and that little bat turn, little whip back into it.
And that breaks a run of 8 behinds by North Melbourne. The Hawks' lead cut to just 1 point. 8 minutes left in the half. Platten from Bones' tap. Ineffective. Chandler likewise. Schwoss to Anthony Stevens. Oh, good mark. Grabbed by Danny Stevens. Player who made a meal of that shot at goal. He'd like to kick one. Will this be one? Graham punches. Allison looks for another free kick.
Oh,
slaps it back. Clever. No one there really. Scholl runs out of room. Archer, can he kick another one? Bang! He's
pummeled.
And Allison looking at the umpire again, but he's having none of that. And North making a change. Mellington is coming back on.
Longmire hit the post, Pete. He had it very close there and had a shot, but just might have done a Percy Jones.
Really, you just struggle to see where North's goals are going to come from other than someone like Allison. No other players. Scholl's been very quiet. They're not playing a traditional centre-half forward. They're running with the smalls. Mellington's in amongst it, but no one's showing much at all in that forward line for North.
Well, Longmire, nearly marked Graham's kick in. Harford, up to half forward. That's a good mark. Any overhead mark today is a good one. Holland, starting to get a few touches in the second quarter. Langford at left half forward. Can Langers kick a goal? He has! It'll bring the house down! Jamie Shanahan hit the post last week. He's never kicked a goal. And goals to Chris Langford are pretty rare.
That's his 33rd career goal, Peter, out of 302 games. So he averages one goal every 10 matches.
But this is a very crucial goal in the context of the game. That North Melbourne got that one there by Archer, but Hawthorn immediately able to answer with probably the best transference of the ball that we've had to date.
Just just shows how critical it was of that missed mark from that kick out. It hit Longmire on the chest, spilt free. Harford was able to clear it. And then Holland in front of Carey with an excellent mark and kick to Langford. So the Hawks are away again. Inside 50. Wayne Carey this time controlling the ball at centre-half back. He's cleaned Nick Holland up so far in this first half. Holland has only had the two touches. Platten in front of Scott. Scott does well. Doesn't infringe. His umpire, Cecilia, calls a bounce between wing and right half forward for the Hawks. There's the drowned rat. Those curls. Magnificent. I don't think we'll ever see him ever cut that hair. Punched on by the Hawthorn side. Overrun by Dixon. Off the ground by Chick. Martin under the hammer. Randall Bone putting pressure, but the ball off the ground straight in the arms of Kapler.
He just about kicked this.
Big Randall has put pressure on. He was the one that wrapped up the tackle right on the goal line at the other end. He's running around. He's making his presence felt, the big fella.
Well, Darren Kapler, a beautiful kick of the ball with his left foot. Directly in front. Kicking from 50, right on the line. The kick off the boot looks pretty good, but it's wide. And it's Hawthorn's fourth behind. They lead by 7. And they've done exceptionally well so far in this game. At 5.5 minutes remaining in the half. It's Hawthorn North Melbourne here at the MCG.
Hawks aiming for their first win in North Melbourne in the last 8 contests. In fact, North have won the last 8. Scott, Anthony Stevens. Quick pick up and kick, gets it to half forward. One-on-one duel. Graham punches from behind, only to see Longmire in the road. The horse goes down towards Allison. Great running mark. Terrific grab. Decides to play on quickly. Allison snaps. It's coming around. And not enough. He clears the pack, including the high flyer, Glenn Archer. So one behind to Brett Allison, 1-2 against his name out of the Roos tally of 2-10, and the difference back to 6 points late in the second quarter at the G. Crummell. Crummell at left half back. Have the outstretched arms of 2 North Melbourne players. Robren loses out. Bell. Punch to the ground again. Allison takes the hand pass, tries to get around his teammate. Good, that was Mellington. Good tackle by Crummell. Harford tries to go off the ground. And we're going to see another ball up. So the Hawks defending desperately down there to protect their 6-point lead. Danny Stevens gives the ball back to the umpire. Over the top, Simpson. Allison, great play for a goal. Scores level.
Excellent piece of work. I was just about to call Brett Allison, really is the only one who looks like getting a goal. And he got that out of perhaps just a little bit of a nod and a wink between he and his teammate Simpson. Simpson, the shorter player, jumps over the contest here and just at the right hand puts it down ever so perfectly in the path of Allison, and he runs on and gets it. He's the danger player just at the moment for the Hawthorn defence. And who could forget against Carlton early in the year where Allison kicked the first 5 goals for North Melbourne.
Well, he kicked 3 goals last week against Richmond. So he's no stranger in front of the big sticks. Always dangerous. And as it showed there, very creative as well. Salmon, the tap out, is sharked now by Robert Scott around the corner. Lekas can't mark. Scholes taken without the ball. It's all Hawthorn now. Kapler runs without the ball. Now back to Simpson, who was part of that goal and the assist. Off to Longmire. Longmire kicked right on the chest of Brad Scott, who leads Allison to the ball. He's kicked with plenty of time as Mellington from North Melbourne comes off the ground to be replaced by Harvey. On centre wing now, Schwoss. Umpire Dennis Rich finds a free kick. And we'll go to North Melbourne. The Bronx cheers from the North Melbourne supporters in the Great Southern Stand.
Yeah, Harvey's on because Pagan's encouraged by the performance of Allison at ground level in the forward line. Needs another crummer.
Well, North Melbourne now, they can raffle it. Chandler and Archer. Lack of communication there. Who wanted it? They both said it's yours. Now the punch from behind was Schwoss. Now the big rat, the little rat, Johnny Platten, breaking away from half back. Goes the bounce. That's not what you've got to do. You've got to touch it on the ground, son. You're small enough. Now his kick is wide. Makes it very difficult for Holland and very easy for Carey. Unfortunate kick from Platten because putting Holland under the hammer, he's already struggling as it is. Carey's being too strong, and it's a defender's day, but that kick makes it difficult for Holland to get a position.
I think these conditions conditions would allow a coach to make a team rule of just no bouncing or touching the ball on the ground today. Be predictable, get out, get the kick.
Carey in front, taps it down to a large pack of players. North Melbourne bottling it up, Martin Pike underneath it. Coming off the best and fairest for Fitzroy and fitting into this North Melbourne side beautifully in their lead up into the finals. They're currently seventh and they desperately need this win to at least substantiate themselves in the eight. As again another ball up, seventh, 11 wins and 9 losses, 111.3%. So the percentage is reasonably healthy. So a good win here, although you won't get much percentage in these conditions, but a win is a good win. Punch clear from Longmire now. Lord had it spent, punched on by Chick. Good work from the Hawthorn side. Langford's up forward, he's already kicked one. His 33rd goal in his career with 302 games. Now Kepler is caught by David King. North Melbourne are getting the feeling they're growing in confidence as the kick goes wide looking for Chandler. His handball conceding ground to Schwoss under the hammer, close to the line, has time and kicks it long up towards centre wing.
Well, Hawthorn, 7-shot mark on the chest. And the big fish is having a good day. A back injury kept him out last week. And of course, enjoying the non-appearance, as it were, of Corey McCurtin. Carey, Holland, flipped forward, Schwoss and Graham. Graham first to recover. Well, probably worth a try. He tried to keep it in. In the end, he's kicked it out of bounds on the floor. So it's a free kick to North Melbourne to be taken by Mickey Martin.
It was really like a soccer cross, that one, wasn't it? That's what he needed. David Beckham.
He's not going to take it. It's Martin Pike. He's going to take it. Lately. Now Carey. Number 12. Shot at midfield. Shrugs the tackle from his opponent, Crummell. Oh, that's a good mark. Lekas. In fact, it's Hassel. Up to Scott, who has Allison as his opponent. He's kicked two goals, but Scott's been productive. Platten.
That's a good option.
Good running. Good running. Scott again needs to sit for him. It doesn't.
Took his eye.
Lately at the bell. Scholl around Crawford. Walks with the numbers. Graham over the top. Now on ground level, Lord, Chandler, Longmire off a step, goes at goal, should kick it, and does, North in front. The Roos get their noses in front for the first time in the match.
Well, John Longmire's playing the around-the-ground role as the ruckman very smartly here. That's the second or third time that he's constructed this defensive wall on the 50-metre line once the ball's in the North Melbourne forward line. Hawthorn trying to get it on out and weren't able to do so. Chandler then in the position to use Longmire when the ball goes back, a little bit of space there to goal.
Well, he's been under the hammer, he's been put into the ruck, he's a traditional full forward, so he's done exceptionally well against one of the favourites of the Brownlow in Paul Salmon, and also kicked a goal, so doing very well the horse, John Longmire. Again, North Melbourne, Anthony Stevens inside 50, slews off his boot, now a chance for the goal kicker in Brent Allison, over the top, it looks pretty good for the North Melbourne side, another one to Fruity.
Three.
But Allison again with his third, very dangerous around goal. Three goals out of five is an exceptional effort from the goal sneak.
We can just see there that Johnny Hassel has the job on him now, but really Brett Allison, the ball's his in the forward line just at the moment. He's been able to create things, he's always in there among it. And just being able to step out, doesn't need much space at all, Brett Allison. A couple of metres, had it then. Took a chance.
Three goals in 6 minutes to North Melbourne, and that's a very good lead under these situations where it's wet. Simpson to half forward. Harvey and Scott. There's the siren for half time. So an excellent finish to the quarter by North Melbourne.
Yeah, under the circumstances, Peter, that is an exceptional finishing because Hawthorn had control of the footy. That was up their forward line probably for 15 or 20 minutes of that quarter. They had many opportunities to score, and then all of a sudden, two or three quick goals, especially in these conditions, it's just it's heartbreaking for a side. So yep. I'm sure Ken Judge will be very disappointed the way the Hawks finished that quarter off.
Yeah, they've taken the match by the scruff of the neck, haven't they? 5-10-40 A 12-point lead at half-time under, we won't call them atrocious conditions, but conditions certainly that players aren't used to this season in the drought. 12 points the margin in favour of the reigning premiers at the MCG.
Peter Mitchell with the latest from the Seven Newsroom. Students occupying an RMIT building in the city warned they'll be billed $50,000 a day. Refugees fleeing the volcano-ravaged island of Montserrat planning a new life in Australia. A shocking night on the state's roads, two dead and several injured in a spate of accidents. A Keilor house severely damaged by fire, believed to have been started by burning chips. Bill Clinton's date in court with Paula Jones, the woman who accused him of sexual harassment. Cosmonauts aboard Mir successfully complete the main repair work to their damaged space station. In sport, England has a lead of just 14 runs with 7 second innings wickets in hand in the 6th test. Greg Norman 2 shots off the lead after the second round of the World Series of Golf in Ohio. And emotions run high for the Western Bulldogs with their last match at Witten Oval. Showers this afternoon and possible hail in Melbourne. It's currently 8 degrees. Peter Mitchell with the latest from the Seven Newsroom. Students occupying an RMIT building in the city warned they'll be billed $50,000 a day. Refugees fleeing the volcano-ravaged island of Montserrat planning a new life in Australia. A shocking night on the state's roads, two dead and several injured in a spate of accidents. A Keilor house severely damaged by fire, believed to have been started by burning chips. Bill Clinton's date in court with Paula Jones, the woman who accused him of sexual harassment. Cosmonauts aboard Mir successfully complete the main repair work to their damaged space station. In sport, England has a lead of just 14 runs with 7 second innings wickets in hand in the 6th test. Greg Norman 2 shots off the lead after the second round of the World Series of Golf in Ohio, and emotions run high for the Western Bulldogs with their last match at Witten Oval. Showers this afternoon and possible hail in Melbourne. It's currently 8 degrees.
Thank you.
Scott's done well, but he's had three kicked on him.
No, two on him.
Two.
Give that last one to
Yes.
Conditions. Holland, a rare mark in front of the dominant Carey.
second, third term. Great lead, great mark. Excellent work from Ben Dixon in front of Dean Laidley.
That is a good mark. It was given, one, the conditions, and two, the closeness and pressure that was applied by the opponent, Dean Laidley. He's right there. But this is excellent work from Dixon. A good long lead, then reaching up, meeting the ball as early as possible. Didn't wait at all for the ball to come to him.
Well, he may have the benefit of a new football. They change the footies every quarter in these conditions, so it's only been playing a couple of minutes. So Dixon, directly in front, the left footer, only two steps. Kick will be close to the line. It may be over, or a mark to Holland, one or the other. Umpire Dennis Rich adjudicating. It'll be a mark to Holland. He'll be pushed right around as he took the mark right next to the goalpost, so he'll be put on a very sharp angle. He's trying to stooge Dennis Rich, but he's been around too long, old Den. Coming on to 43, but he should not be a problem to put this through, and Hawthorn's fifth. As we see the North Melbourne players on the side, King and Chandler ready to put pressure just in case Holland runs off his line. So they're waiting for that call from the umpire of play on. As soon as they hear that,
it's a great shot.
They burst in. So Holland under a bit of pressure.
Oh, no! Hits the post. Wow.
There was just all too much going on in Nick Holland's head then. He had these two blokes on his left. He was concerned about them. And he just all tightened up. And it was the old steel elbow that you get in tennis. He just wanted to get it over the net. Well, he just wanted to scrub it over and missed it.
Well, now what he's going to do is...
he's going to kick a big bomb and he's going to kick it from 60. Yeah.
He'll put it through with a torp.
Well, he and Danny Stevens will be taking kicking lessons this week. Danny's was just as bad.
So, Nick Holland, his kick will land in the square. He needs a big high-flying mark. The Martin punch is clearing. Excellent work straight onto the chest of Carey. He drives it out of the North Melbourne back line, straight up to centre wing, and the North Melbourne side are away.
Crummell tries to paddle it away from the pack. Lekas. He was going to try to get it to Harford, but he couldn't do that. So the difference is still 12 points in favour of the Roos.
Carey's choice there, just with a big long kick out of the defensive area, is a very sound decision.
13 and 2, Wayne Carey. Salmon, Bell, had it, dropped it, tackled by Harford, ineffective. Blakey trying to barge his way through the pack. Is it Blakey or Pike? Blakey. Those former Roy boys. Longmire dragged off it by Salmon. Crummell over the top. Simpson across his body to half forward. Robren. Crawford. Looks not to go with Crawford, but goes with the long kick. Kapler from behind Stevens. Simpson to King. Kick dropping a little bit short. Archer gets rid of his opponent. Allison tried to get it to him. Hassel. Taylor. Crummell in trouble, slung, ball jarred free, Archer, player on his own is Anthony Stevens, kicks from 49 metres, not a bad kick, oh, terrific goal! The Roos go further ahead.
Isn't it always the case, Terry, when at one end, a certain goal was missed and it runs down the other end and the opposition make it pay?
Yeah, I think what's important here is just the structure of North Melbourne, in that they have players just back behind the ball, and more often than not you can find a little time and space with possession of the ball when you're back off it. Stevens on that occasion had that and made the most of the chance with a goal.
Well, 15 possessions to Anthony Stevens, with the last being an excellent goal from 55. And what we've seen all day, the ball hasn't travelled all that far, but that was an excellent execution. As Paul Salmon receives a free kick for two high in the ruck, and his kick lands inside 50, it's wide. But it's the North Melbourne defence again in Martin Pike, sells the dummy, elects to run his 10 metres, kicks it long, and finds the running Craig Scholl in front. In these conditions, it's wet, it's slippery. Players in front will win. Archer was in front, couldn't take the mark. Strong work from Scott. Graham now butters up. Kicks under pressure. Platten at ground level is good. Tries to keep control. Simpson shows his desperation for throwing himself into the mud. Crummell trying to be clever. May pay the price. Bell's handball over the top allows Stevens to kick it off the ground. Now some finessing from Scott.
took his eye off it, albeit briefly. Allison putting the pressure on. Now Tony Woods, left half back, will have a bit of time to steady, because up forward he has Richard Taylor, and he makes no mistake.
Richard Taylor at left half back. Rain gets a little bit heavier. Hawks with the numbers. Platten gets rid of Scott. Only momentarily. Schwass belts it forward. Under to see the Hawks on the end of it. Kick comes up from Chick. Now Lord. Won't be a score. It's out of bounds. At least it's up Hawthorn's end. As North Melbourne enjoyed the biggest lead of the match so far. 6-11-47. The Hawks 4-5-29. One of their goal kickers, Chris Langford, today in the second quarter. So 5 metres from the behind post. Holland and Carey. Carey contesting a boundary throw and didn't seem to do too many of those last week. Blakey. Platten will lead in the race for the ball. Needs a good shepherd from the big fish. He gets it. Kicking up an under job. Harford showed courage to try to mark that. Langford to Crawford. A little bit of sleep there.
I tell you what, Shane Crawford, there's one thing that's frustrating me about his game, is this handball where his body weight's going away from the target.
Wrong option.
And firing off. No, I don't know about the option, but he should have his body weight moving in the direction at which he wants to handball, rather than trying to give it off and then get the body out of the way of the contact.
Scott and Platten. Still Platten keeps it in play. Chandler only kicks it as far as Holland. He may kick a goal with that run. He missed a centre before. It's coming around, but not enough, I don't think. One behind, the goal umpire will indicate. So two behinds in this quarter. Vastly different kicks from Nick Holland, and the difference back to 17 points. The rain still tumbles down. It's like a night game now with the lights on. King will kick in. So under these conditions, you would expect North to prevail.
Holland getting a couple of critical involvements in the game in this second half, which are a key to Hawthorn's chances.
David King has played on, so he earns himself another stat. He gained 20 metres and kicked it up towards centre wing. With John Longmire has contested the ball, so it's now out of bounds. 12 minutes remaining in the third term. 17 points, North Melbourne. Robren driving it forward, putting pressure on the North Melbourne defence. The Hawks desperately need a goal. Nick Holland had a chance, missed one from the line. Here's now a chance for the right-footed Kepler. That's long. Into the goal square, punched by Carey, it's still alive. Chandler, clever, might have been a throw, but the umpire was unsighted, so he had to call play on. Carey's kick is clever.
Ooh.
Excellent kick, had no other option than to put it, just dribble it over the line, and that's just a bit of a class act from Wayne Carey. Number 18, captain of North Melbourne, premiership captain, 3 times best and fairest, and 16 possessions today at centre-half back on Nick Holland. Showing him exactly how it's done. Salmon's tap only finding Schwass. North Melbourne starting to dominate. Beautiful goal earlier from Anthony Stevens from 55. As Brendan Crummell takes Brett Chandler over the line for another throw in. Centre wing here at the MCG.
Chandler's been a good addition to the North Melbourne side. I mean, the three ex-Fitzroy players they've picked up, Chandler, Pike and Mellington, all playing today, really have given some extra depth to the North Melbourne side.
Another punch from Salmon, still favoured North Melbourne right midfield. Along by handball, finding Schwass. He in turn, desperate kick along the ground, gains 25 metres, so we're going to have another throw in, exactly the same spot.
Another Fitzroy player has been a great buy for them too. Number 12, Johnny Blakey.
Certainly. Yes. So there's the Fitzroy producing good footballers, they just didn't have a good side. It's funny that. Centre wing. Salmon and Longmire. Salmon in front. It's experience. Even Stevens. Now to Schwass. Off to Stevens. His long kick inside 50. But running out from fullback. And safe hands. We see number 34 for Hawthorn, Mark Graham.
Graham is going to go across the ground. Needs to be accurate. It is. Harford. That's not. Lekas will have to chase. And he'll need to get a good bounce. So two Hawthorn players are there. Lekas and Robren out of bounds on the floor.
Yeah, the wrong player actually took the ball there. Lekas was running towards the Hawthorn goal. He should have been given the right of way there by Robren. Robren should have done the shepherding.
Johnny Blakey, about whom we were just speaking. Clears the pack. Archer, will he go off the ground? No, picks it up, slams it home and kicks another one. No, he's hit the post. again, hanging on by the skin of their teeth, the Hawks. 1-2 to Glenn Archer, 18 effective scoring shots to 10, and the difference is 18 points. 6-12 to 4-6 as we approach the halfway mark of the third quarter. Kick in, favours the member stand side. Harford, mark, free kick, whatever. Harford from right half back. Over the top, Anderson. Down to Chandler. Scott paddles it forward for Law. Anderson's in the row. Kapler tries to go off the ground. Succeeds. Still chases. Can't keep it in play. Tried to get it to Chick. The boundary umpire will throw it in front of the MCC member stand.
Darren Kapler. Former Swan. Big left footer. Great to watch on the run, kicking goals from 50 to 60 metres. Saw that many times up at the SCG, as Daniel Harford will receive a free kick. There it is. Right half forward, about 80 metres out from goal, so it may be two or three kicks. That's a good drop punt kick from Daniel Harford. Robren in the middle of the pack, driven down. Taylor ducks his head. Play on to the call, good decision. Langford throwing his weight around, and experience. Now Aaron Lord with a chance, caught high by Stevens, by Simpson it is. Now Lekas, play on to the call off the side of the boot. Scott under pressure, ball still alive. Big Mickey Martin, that's it, right through the middle of the pack. Good driver in heavy traffic, Martin. Now the exciting King out of half back through the centre. He's got the running Allison, also Hassel. Hassel's quick, does very well. Lifts the ball up, looking for Graham, unable to grab it. Now Graham, under the hammer, Scholl, caught, drops it, flat, Pion's the call. Crummell punches the ball off the ground, over the line.
Well, I thought you could only dispose of the ball either by foot or punching it away with a clenched hand. And Craig Scholl really did neither of those in that little incident.
Well, Scholl's been very good so far this year with the goals. He's kicked 36, plus his two behinds today, so 36 goals for the season has been an excellent return for him, especially spending a lot of his time off the half back line. Now Chick, number 17 for Hawthorn, under pressure, maybe he should have steadied a little more. Now Carey, one of the North Melbourne best, at centre half back off to Mick Martin, who's a long way out from full back. His kick inside 50, Robren off the ground by Stevens. Now the running Pike has a chance under the hammer from Lekas, who's close. Pike gets his kick to the front of the square. It's one-on-one. Crummell the punch. Off the ground. Allison a goal.
Number four.
Ever the opportunist. Brett Allison running with the flight of the ball. If you keep running in the forward line, you're always a chance. And he's one of the best at it.
I mean, all he needs to work with, Allison, more often than not, is a contest from the other North Melbourne players. Pike, this is a very good kick. It gives it plenty of height. And Scholl just pushing and shoving, yeah, providing some sort of contest at the top of the square, falls free. What Allison does, he just runs hard at the contest, creating opportunities that may not normally exist for other players.
245 career goals to Allison, and that lead under these conditions, even at this stage of the third quarter, you couldn't really see North getting rolled from here, could you? King, Scholl, Crummell. Still shot. Up in front of goal, nearly a mark. Harvey snaps and misses. One behind to Brent Harvey. His first score of the afternoon. And Hawthorn languishing on still just the four goals.
And Pete, over the last month, the second half performance of the Hawthorn side has really been questioned. This has been an opportunity for them to put something up, but really it's just sort of reinforcing that particular thought at the moment that they don't have the ability to keep going in the second half of the game.
Free kick was against John Longmire. The umpire says play on. The advantage rule. Woods kick up towards half forward. No mark paid. Anderson off the ground. Lord.
This should be a goal.
One should provide a shepherd. Lord into goal, and he does kick a goal. A badly needed one for the Hawks. Aaron Lord kicks his first and the Hawks' fifth. And finally something for the Hawks supporters to cheer about. That breaks a run of five unanswered goals by North Melbourne. 7-13 to 5-6.
And so this one is really just scrounged around. Again, Lord gets himself in a good position is that he can run onto the ball. That's where forwards need to place themselves, particularly the small forwards, is where the ball goes over their head, so to speak, and they can run straight onto goal, their directions flowing that particular way, giving them every chance.
Good effort from Aaron Lord. He left the field earlier with a nasty gash on his forehead after a clash with Wayne Schwoss. So he's come back on with steri strips on his face and put one through. Badly needed goal for the Hawks as Stevens and Richard Taylor and Randall Bone wrap each other up in the centre quagmire. Reasonably heavy now. We've had heavy rain for most of the afternoon, but it's now stopped. Platten, fresh air shot. Now the big horse, Johnny Longmire, unable to control it. Now Stevens chips it across on his left foot to Simpson. Premiership player in the third, seconds and first for North Melbourne. A pretty good milestone for the young kid as Bone, as well as Tony Woods, they wrap the ball up right on the corner of the square. 6.5 minutes to three-quarter time. 19 points, North Melbourne. Another throw-up. All bodies everywhere. Stevens tries to hook it back off the ground attempt. Now, good work from Harford. That's good courage. Throwing your body in. An equally courageous effort from Randall Bone, who takes a well-judged chest mark. Daniel Chick has been quiet in this third term. King has made it very difficult for him to score possessions, but he kicked a goal in the first quarter. He's been very quiet since, but it was a good kick. Now Schwoss. Half back to Carey, who's been dominant on Nick Holland. The Carey kick, very laconic, but very effective. Straight under the chest of Stevens. He has the Craig Scholl lead. Puts it in front of him. Scholl, clever. Kicks it off the ground. And Mark Graham, typical defender, runs the ball over the line. 25 metres around from the North Melbourne behind post. Left back pocket. Mark Graham had a reasonable game. Spent a bit of time up the forward line this year with Ken Judge trialling him as a forward. Kicking about 13 or 14 goals. And Scholl trying to tap it out of the air. Now Bone off the ground attempt. Hassel, his kick up towards centre wing over the top off Bell. Good work from King, keeps his eye on the ball. Chick off the ground. Pike, who's caught, does it well, keeps his feet, bounces up opponents and gives it off to Anthony Stevens on centre wing for North Melbourne. He drives it into the 50-metre line. A high flyer, no one can mark. Lekas off the side of the boot, turns into a decent old torpedo. And King went to go. Now he shrugs off the tackle and puts it on the boot inside 50.
King's kick. Allison, he's already kicked four. Carey farms it out. Simpson, this way, that way. Harford's got him. Robren, quick kick, not a bad one either. Comes to Chick, backs himself, gives himself a little bit of time, but kicks it straight into the arms of Bell, who says thanks very much and turned to King. No one on the mark this time. Anderson replacing Robertson, the selected side. That's a good kick. Long bomb by Anderson and rushed through for one behind down there by Johnny Hassel.
You called it quite accurately there, Peter. Anderson, one of his real strengths is that he does kick the ball long and kicks it well. Sometimes you, in these slippery conditions, you can get a little bit too cute with the ball, but a player of his ability coming off half-back and being prepared to kick long and directly into the forward line is a real advantage.
I think this is going to have to come back again. It is. Graham wants more to kick it in. 7-14, North Melbourne, 5-6, Hawthorn. Robren takes the mark. Simpson will stand it. Robren at right half back. Bone the target. Punched away by Longmire. Anthony Stevens and Harford. Platten's got him. And it will be a ball up on centre wing. Wind is still coming very strongly from the west or northwest. The rain has momentarily eased, and that's good. So conditions a little bit better. Longmire's kick smothered. He might get another chance. Shuffled out the back. Harford goes off the ground. Gets it up towards centre wing. Woods. Bell's got him. Platten comes into a player tackle. And it will be a ball up again. Still in the centre wing position, right in front of our commentary box here in the northern stand. Hawks would love another couple of goals before three-quarter time. Paddled further forward by King. He cannons over the boundary line. So does the footy. But North Melbourne have gained another 25 to 30 metres.
And David King returned last week after a couple of weeks out with suspension. But giving himself a chance now with this last couple of rounds to run himself into some good form coming up to the final series.
Johnny Longmire takes it, but he doesn't get very far with it. So the light getting a lot better.
That's because the lights are on.
No, I know they're on, but apart from that fact,
yeah,
the clouds seem to have cleared away a little bit. We might get a good last quarter. Taylor fumbles. Harford under pressure. Well, they can't get it out of this area, either team. And the umpire will ball it up.
Johnny Platton always underneath the packs. Been an excellent player for the Hawthorn side over the past 10 or 12 years. Over 250 games, four premierships. Just a champion bloke.
Hard to believe it was 10 years ago he won the Brownlow, wasn't it?
Oh, yeah, but the rat. Lovely guy, great sense of humour and always in for a lot of fun. Excellent player around the club. And obviously he'd be keen to continue his role at Hawthorn into 1998, depending on his fitness and how his body stands up. And now it's Anthony Stevens, whose body's very, very strong for the North Melbourne side. The ball finding it very difficult to get close to the goals at either end. North Melbourne have 7-14-56, 20-point leaders over Hawthorn, 5-6. They led by 12 points at half-time. They've kicked 2 goals, 4 so far. 2 Hawthorn, 1 goal, 2. Now Simpson close to the boundary line. The left footer looks pretty good. It'll land in the goal square unless it's punched through it. It is by Robren. So another rush behind to North Melbourne. 15 behinds. But the ball has been very slippery. And the rain has bucketed down in the first and second terms. It's now clear, still very overcast. The lights are on at the MCG, so Crummell. Good mark and good kick to Kepler. He can't finish it off. Now Schwoz is clever, dances around Kepler, but steps over the line and out of bounds. So Hawthorn side currently sitting 13th on the ladder with 8 wins and 12 losses and a very dismal percentage. So no chance for the Hawks to play in this year's finals. But on the other hand, North Melbourne looking for a back-to-back flags, and always very difficult to score those, especially under these conditions when you're finishing, you're in 7th, moving into the finals. As Stevens, his kick now to Craig Scholl outside 50, close to the boundary line. Team rule says he's got to kick to the front of the square. He abides by those. Mellington has just come on the ground over his head. Again, a throw-in, but directly on the other side of the field, about 35 metres around from the North Melbourne goal. A minute and a half left. It's North Melbourne by 21 points.
Throw in. Longmire gets front position from Bone. Taylor taken to the ground at the tackle. Stevens, who's had a busy third quarter, left foots it out to the front of goal. Bone in front. Ball punched away by Groom and also Scholl, and through for another rush behind to the Roos.
John Longmire doing the ruck work for North Melbourne, has been in that role all day. It's been quite impressive for mine, the way in which he's been able to get in and body hard against the taller opponent in Salmon and perhaps the little bit bigger opponent in Bone. But just that last boundary throw, and he did the ruck work and then plied the next tackle. I think it's a very encouraging signs for John Longmire.
23 scoring shots to 11. And the difference translates to 22 points. Leckus in the back pocket for Hawthorn. Target was Bone, caught well out of position. Crummell gives it to him. Carey tries to get back quickly. Bell, his teammate, beats him to it. Anderson a chance to pick it up on the wing. Pressured by Lord, it's out of bounds. At that location for another throw-in as we tick down to three-quarter time. The difference at half-time was 42-28, 12 points in favour of the Roos, so they've extended it in this third quarter. Bone and Longmire. Pike, a little give to Schwoz. Schwoz's kick up the half-forward. Robren, Mellington, long hand pass. Oh, number 5 coming up for Allison. If he can get a handle on it, he can't. Will he go off the ground again? Didn't get a chance to. And Leckers takes it over the boundary line for a throw-in in North Melbourne's right forward pocket.
The Hawks are straight onto him there with a hassle on the inside, and Leckers
focus on the outside. But as you call Pete, Allison, there's always a chance for him to pull something out of even a tight situation like that.
Like he did a few minutes back.
Groom and Robren. Mellington over the top, the high flyer. Groom's handball, very clever to Scholl. Around the corner, across the face of goal. Another behind to the Ruse.
Three to Craig Scholl.
17. 17 behinds. As Pete mentioned, three behinds to Craig Scholl. Brett Allison leading the goal kicking with four. Singles to Anthony Stevens, Glenn Archer, and Johnny Longmire.
But he's the only vulnerable goal kicker in the match, isn't he?
Goal kickers for Hawthorn, Kepler, Lord, Chick, and Langford. And also Johnny Platten. As King is bitten by the siren, still has time to throw it on the boot, but to no avail. Does not count. David King, who went off the ground in the first term with a pretty heavy knock to the around the rib area, but seems to have recovered very well. Very consistent running off the half-back line. Very, very quick player. Damaging out of that half-back line for North Melbourne. So at three-quarter time, it's North Melbourne, 7-17-59, leading Hawthorn 5-6-36.
Thank you.
Stevens. Chick, if he can pick it up, he can, onto Robren. The Hawks need a couple of goals, and they want them quickly to give themselves any chance of taking out this match. Looked a good chance earlier. Quarter time, they led 2-2 to 1-7. But North Melbourne, with some late goals in the second quarter, pinched the lead of 12 points at the main change, and they haven't really looked back since. Allison, the only multiple goal kicker, he has four. Scott runs into a brick wall. The two Scots tangle. Platten. And the rat underneath the bottom of the pack, isn't he always? One of the latest authors in AFL ranks. Appropriately named the rat. 250 plus games for the Hawks. Hungarian Brownlow medalist, he's had a pretty good game too. Longmire taps it out. Harper didn't get anywhere, good tackle. Anthony Stevens, Langford, one of Hawthorn's goal kickers today. Woods, onto Taylor. Taylor down to half forward, too far for Lord. The ball might bounce kindly for him. Laidley, 150th game, he wanted to do better than that. Applies a good tackle, and that's holding the ball. The first time today we've seen a holding the ball decision. And the Junkyard Dog from fullback takes the kick.
Up towards centre wing it goes, Craig Scholl. Buffeted out by Darren Kepler. And the ball's just sat next to the boundary line, and Schwartz just helped it over. He was in no hurry.
Pete, you were right just in your assessment there earlier. It was at three goals late in the second quarter that North Melbourne really blew the game apart. Hawthorn were working very, very hard within the context of the game up to that period, but then they just rose to the top, North Melbourne. Three very good goals, and they've continued on very consistently since then.
They currently lead by 23 points.
It's a big lead under these conditions, five.
Yeah, and we see Peter Bell, who's been sitting down for a bit of this game on that sideline, the notorious bench with 14 possessions. Crawford in front of Blakey, play on to the call. As Blakey's remonstrating with umpire Sosia, asking the question. Quiet day for Shane Crawford. John Blakey's done an excellent job on him. It's Crawford's always been dangerous in that roving midfield position for Hawthorn. Punch cleared for Stevens, now to Schwoss. Concedes ground back to Laidley. 150 games for Dean Laidley today. Averaging at just under 15 per year. The kick from Archer. Up towards centre wing, Hassel. Under the hammer from Allison. Good work from Brett Allison. The second effort as Robren sees the ball over the line, out of bounds. And Chris Groom was looking for a deliberate out of bounds.
He's a bit optimistic, I think.
Certainly is, with a wet footy. Very difficult to control close to the line, albeit anywhere. Be a throw in on the 50. Just around the corner from the Hawthorn goals. Now it's Dixon. Off to Simpson. Has a ping of the big ones. Kick looks pretty good. Adam Simpson, what a magnificent kick for goal. That's their eighth.
He's had a good day, Simpson. That's his 16th kick.
It's been quite an impressive game from Simpson, the way in which he's been. And it hasn't been a real great season for him. I think he's been dropped, you know, three times through the year and had to spend a couple of weeks each time in the reserves. And now he's back with another opportunity. And today's performance, he's really made the most of it. Very aggressive at the contest, aggressive at the ball, and excellent skills finishing off there.
Adam Simpson's first goal, making the task difficult and maybe well nigh impossible for the Hawks to get up from here. Simpson again with a chance. He'll go off the ground, gets it inside 50. A little flip up to Allison from Scholl. The only multiple goal kicker in the match is not going to add to his tally with that kick. One behind, kicked by Brett Allison. Four goals, three against his name. 8-18. So arguably, the difference could have been a lot more than the 30 points that North Melbourne now enjoy over the Hawks. Allison and Kepler. Platten kept at bay. Longmire across the outstretched arms of the Rat into the pocket. Crummell takes the mark for Hawthorn. He's going to transfer play to the outer side. Might be dangerous. It's not, because Salmon's taken the mark, and three North Melbourne players were waiting for crumbs. Woods. Taylor had made a lead for him. He's gone over the head of Taylor. keeper takes the mark. Martin Pike has been solid today. Archer backs into the pack. Nearly brought it down. Crummell applies a tackle. Platten held by Scott. Still Platten. Around the outstretched arms of Simpson. Schwoz in front. Lord knocks it over the line. Throw in centre wing outer side. 16 minutes left in the match. The difference is 30 points. North Melbourne coasting along at 8-18. And Hawthorn 5 goals 6.
Throw in. Salmon's rucked tirelessly all day, just as much as Longmire, so they've been very good performers today. Longmire kicking a goal, and an excellent mark to Peter Bell on half-back for the north side. He goes inboard, looking for the centre of the ground, looking for Scholl, can't mark it, but brings it down, not allowing the Hawthorn defenders run away with it. That's good work from Craig Scholl. Currently leading the goal-kicking for North Melbourne with 36 goals, but has Brett Allison on his hammer with 33, with 4 today, Allison. Salmon, tap, Richard Taylor, not all that effective. Now Pike, the rebound. Straight through Chandler Arms. Now Scott bouncing around Platten. Sends it into the forward line, but Mark Graham has probably been Hawthorn's best player.
Very good call there, Russell. He's been very good on Archer right throughout. Handled Archer fairly well in the one-on-one duels, but then has also read the play very well, dropping back just as he did on that occasion.
Robrin's kick up towards centre wing. Johnny Platten, who's been amongst it, overruns the ball. Now to Hassel. He's had a couple kicked on him by Brett Allison. So has Brad Scott for Hawthorn. So Allison's been a real match winner. Aaron Lord was caught with the ball. Play on to the call. It might have been deemed dropping the ball, but it doesn't matter. The North Melbourne players have got it. Simpson can give it off to Lely. Good work from Taylor. Holds him up momentarily. But he still has time to put it on the chest of Wayne Schwoz, so it's becoming a bit too easy for the North Melbourne side. The Hawthorn pressure is diminishing. They started off excellently. Good punch from Robrin. Now to Harford. His little chip is wide, so that's a reflection of how the Hawthorn side are going at the moment, and he knows exactly what I'm talking about. So it'll be a free kick to Brett Chandler, who just replaced David King about a minute ago. King was knocked heavily in the first term, so Denis Pagan may be thinking, well, I'll just give David King a bit of a rest leading into next week's all-important match leading into the finals. So it's the North Melbourne side leading by 30 points, and Hawthorn playing from memory at this stage.
Yeah, there's real concerns there for Hawthorn to think that they've lost their last six games by an average greater than 8 goals.
Wow.
When prior to that they won those 5 and were really looking at its finals berth. The last 6 weeks have been a very,
they always
very
started off well
time.
In the first half they always performed well and then dropped off after half time.
Robrin to Dixon, marking contest at 50. Lately would love to kick a goal in this game. Lekas sees it over the boundary line in front of him. He's Lately's 150th. Hasn't really been in the play today that much, with 7 kicks. Plenty of worries in the Hawk box. I would say that they're not going to win this one from here, so just one to try to get back on the credit side of the ledger, which has been so difficult in the last few weeks. Taylor runs into Chandler. Good tackle by Salmon. Ball jarred free. Simpson on Harford. Umpire gets it go again. Crummell. Now paddled out the back. Salmon's had a good day. Graham. Be out on the full. Bell asking the question of the boundary umpire. He was about 25 to 30 metres behind the play, but he's going to throw it in. 66 plays 36. 8-18 to 5-6. Longmire. Oh, Salmon all over him like a rash there. Kepler. Off a step, long left footer, two-on-two duel, North defence reigns supreme. Chick upends Laidley, Platten, and the mark to Holland. One of the few times today that he's been able to get away from Carey.
Very good guarding there from Carey, going to cut off the inboard piece of movement there from Holland from the outset.
Now Kepler has a lead up forward, and that's okay. The mark has been taken by Lord. Not really that much closer.
He's had a very good first year with Hawthorn, Aaron Lord.
Especially the first part of the year, Terry.
Yeah. Yep, to change clubs and then slot in and play every game. Well done.
Aaron Lord from 45 metres. Has he hooked it? To one of the goal umpire. It might be a goal, it is. Aaron Lord becomes the first multiple goal kicker for the Hawks today. He's got his second, and it gives them a smidgen of hope with 12 and a half minutes remaining in the match, 8-18 to 6-6.
It does give them a hope in this one. I think this centre bounce now becomes very, very crucial, that Hawthorn need to get it out. Salmon does give them that opportunity from here. If they are able to control the ball, just as they did on that occasion, with some good use of the ball, they are quite possibly here with a chance of another couple of quick goals.
So the ball back in the centre. 66 plays 42. Salmon gets the knockout, the running half it. The Hawks, if they can slip one through now, it makes it a decent ball game. Platten under the pack, Anderson off to Martin. Good work from the Ruse. They control the ball beautifully. Wayne Carey just takes one on the top of his right shoulder. So he's making it very difficult for Nick Holland to have any effect on this game for Hawthorn. Carey's done exceptionally well, an excellent first half. 16 kicks, 3 handballs, 3 marks. It was Nick Holland, 6 kicks, no handballs and 5 marks up forward. Now to Dixon. Handball has put Platten under pressure, but it was equally as good to secure the ball. Now the big high flies, a good punch from North Melbourne, but there was a push in the back. I think it might have been against either Carey or Martin. The free kick will go to Holland or Langford, one of those two in the pack. Nick Holland it is. So coming in for his 8th kick. And this kick's a pretty good one. It'll land it right in the goal square. One-on-one, Blakey and Shane Crawford. And the mark is paid to yeah. Blakey. He plays on quickly. I think he was a bit confused. There might have been a...
No, it was well played there by Aaron Lord. A little bit shifty there, just hiding behind the goalpost, so to speak. But popped out at the right time. Then Blakey tried to con the umpire that he hadn't... See this here, Blakey's unaware that Lord's there. He's off. Lord gets him. Lord even quizzed it as well. You should have kept going, Aaron. You had him cold, mate.
So it's play on now. Into the centre of the ground. It's pretty muddy. Brad Scott pushed out of it by Chandler. Now Scott keeps his feet. Smothered kick inside 50 to the Hawthorn forward line. Wrapped up is Simpson by Salmon. Now Daniel Chick. Already kicked one for Hawthorn. Lawrence spent a lot of time on the bench. His ball is smothered. Now Mickey Martin, the big fullback. Beautifully caught by Daniel Chick. Great second effort from the young Hawk forward. Now Lawrence has an opportunity. Bit of time if he can pick it up. Size up an option. He doesn't. Decides, let me kick it off the ground and I'll gain 30 metres for the side. Out of bounds it goes. Just 11 minutes left in this game. And it is North Melbourne by 24 points.
Approaching the halfway mark of the quarter. Salmon, pressured by Anthony Stevens. Platten, Harvey's got him. So too is Anderson.
And a ball up.
That's 257th game. It doesn't look any different. He played his first. Salmon, well that's too high, isn't it, on Simpson? You would reckon he's going to get a free kick. Free kick's just about even. 8 to North Melbourne, the Hawks a couple more. Mellington, who can take a big mark, and he takes that one. Took a ripper last week against Richmond in the goal square. Good skills there. Saw the opening, saw the lead. Danny Stevens has taken the mark. Mr. Sitter on the siren to end the first quarter. Carey making a lead. Danny must fancy himself from further out. He's missed that one as well, but to his credit, we'll say it was a centering kick. Laidley a chance. Good shepherd by Allison. Now Archer bends it around. One behind. Kicked by the Norm Smith medalist of last year. Glenn Archer has 1 goal, 3. 8-19 to 6-6. Was the 27 scoring shots to 12. And the difference is 25 points. Graham straight down the ground. Salmon his target. Didn't find him. Finds the horse instead. He'll be kicking from right on 50. Those kicks have to be really accurate or you let your opposition in.
See, Wayne Carey's run right down there, Peter. I think he's looking for his 400th goal, sitting on 399 at the moment.
Ball fisted away up towards Scholl. Schwoss. Laidley. Laidley outside 50. Big punch by Graham, or big fist. Scott on Platten, effective tackle. Taylor. Around Scholl. Kicks in the Kappa direction. Schwoss may beat him to it before Dixon gets there and Laidley with him, but it's out of bounds on centre wing on the outer side with just under 9 minutes left in the match.
Denis Pagan will be very pleased with the form of Schwoss and Stevens and these guys coming into the finals, because they're an integral part of the North Melbourne Grand Final success for 1997. Experienced campaigners, premierships under their belt from last year. Similar with this man, John Longmire, who missed the Grand Final and the premiership win. We saw some very emotional scenes last year with him in tears in arms of Wayne Carey after the siren. And no man deserves, I suppose, a premiership more than him. If North Melbourne are going to win it again, they need him firing. And he's done an excellent job today playing in the ruck as Brad Scott and Brent Harvey playing a little bit of chesty cuffs. Harvey can just point at the scoreboard as Scott continues with it all. Mellenton out of the ruck, out bustles Salmon. Now Simpson is probably one of North Melbourne's best players today under the pack. Kicked a beautiful goal on the run from the boundary line with the left foot earlier in this term.
Yeah, there's no doubt that you include him in the bunch of best players there. Russ Stevens, Anthony Stevens, he's been a continual workhorse right throughout the game as well. Pike City across halfback, and we've noted Blakey's job on Crawford.
Inside 50 now, Schwoss a chance off the ground. Archer keeps the ball alive, thumps it back onto the Graham legs, and it could have been out of bounds on the full if the boundary umpire was a little closer, but if there's any doubt, he can't make the call, so it'll be a throw-in. 5 metres around from the North Melbourne behind post. Salmon and Mellenton. Mellenton in front now, Mark Graham, probably Hawthorn's best. The kick still putting pressure on the Hawthorn side. Hassel met heavily by Archer. Now to Graham. Again, the long left footed. Excellent body work from Mick Martin. Out bustling Nick Holland. Allowing the ball to go out of bounds in between halfback and centre wing for the Hawthorn side.
Just look at the size of Mick's chest there. And Nick Holland's a big man, but Mick Martin has him paling away a little bit.
Bench presses nearly 300 pounds, I think, Big Mick.
Robin and Mellenton contest. Oh, half a top one there. Yeah. He's come out second best. He's limping.
Just a kicking across the body there, and the player coming in from the inside, making contact with the knee. He looks okay. So it's always a dangerous one. Here it is. Here's the kick, and Simpson coming in hard on the knee.
It can be a lot worse than it is. Let's hope it's only minor. He seems to be moving okay. Certainly sting on a day like today. Harford's kick to midfield. To all North Melbourne, Wayne Schwoss. To Carey. Lawrence gallops after him. Longmire in front of Lord. Takes the mark at left centre wing.
Carey did that with a little bit of arrogance as well, which is a danger for opposition sides coming into the finals. He's getting his touch.
Schwoss, two best and fairests in Roo Land. Onto the horse. Johnny Longmire. Coleman medalist back in 1990. Kicks up towards full forward. Archer from the back tries to outmark Graham. Nearly a mark. Crummell has to punch it further forward.
A good gear.
Moves with the numbers. Scholl snaps but misses. Might have missed all of the prize, I think. That's out of bounds, is it? No. One behind.
But just a very good, sharp, quick give there by Archer. You know, he didn't try and get his body free with the ball. Was committed just getting the ball out of the contest and did so with an excellent quick handball.
26 points is the margin in favour of the Roos. Taylor this time takes the Graham kick in effectively. Danny Stevens on the mark. Taylor a little bit uncertain as to where to go. Finally Salmon in front. At the back is Robren. Neither can bring it down. The ball's still very greasy. A few little puddles around the ground. Something we haven't seen all this year virtually. Rain just started almost on the opening siren. The reserves game today was played at the Punt Road Oval, which North Melbourne also won. Harford, middle up and under kick. Anderson, Platten comes at him. Test of strength, out of bounds. two multiple goal kickers in the match. Brett Abelson with 4-3 and Aaron Lord for Hawthorn, who's kicked two. Promising start by the Hawks. They led at the first change and were only a couple down at half time. Oh, the Rat nearly had his head taken off. He'll get the free kick. Platten, left centre wing, leading the Hawks today. Martin, no, Holland, Bell, pressured by Woods. Pike,
it's a throw. The throw against Peter Bell off the ground there, Peter. And umpire Brett Allen was very close.
That's fair enough, but I mean, you see a lot of those on days like today.
Yeah, I think that'd be the first one they've called.
Correct. Martin in front, Holland taps down. Pike, strength by the former Fitzroy stalwart. Simpson couldn't complete the mark. Bell, a little give to Mellington. North playing with plenty of gusto now, and Scott kicks the half forward.
The half forward kick now from Craig Scholl. Uses his body beautifully. Wayne Schwoss on the left boot. Kicks for the big one. Puts it through. That's the sealer for the North Melbourne side. What a great finish by North, running off that half back line. Starting with a quick couple of handballs. A kick out of defence from Pike. And then handballs from Mellington to Bell. Right through the centre of the ground. And then finish it off by Wayne Schwoss. So it's great to see when a player can finish off with a goal from good play like this.
Well, it was probably the best piece of play that we've seen all day. Yeah, the conditions have made it difficult to link a number of possessions together, but North Melbourne with the run down this near side, and then Schwoss just going hard down the outer side, being there to finish it off.
16 kicks to Wayne Schwoss and his first goal. So might be a little bit of a percentage boost for North Melbourne in the end. It didn't appear as though it was going to be that way early. The scores were close for most of the day. Chandler and Scott. Chandler tried to go off the ground. Scott eventually got it back to Lord. Robren, a little give to Lekas. Taylor or Kapler could have taken it. Finally, Kapler. Started on the bench today. Trelevin left early. Obviously injured. Carey punches with effect. Clears the zone and out of bounds. Good stats for Carey, 17-3, played at half back pretty well all day.
Just think, Terry, the way Hawthorn are going very wide, you'd think they were in front. Like they're really not using that corridor well enough.
Yeah, that's right. I think they've just been squeezed and under pressure consistently, and now they're just really the leaf on the stream at the moment, just floating wherever North Melbourne pressure takes them.
Spiral punt by Pike. Off the ground, down to Scholl and Crummell. Chandler, out of bounds. So a throw in at North Melbourne's left half forward flank. We've got under 5 minutes remaining in the match.
He's a bit of a part-time player today, Brett Chandler, on and off the bench. Salmon, number four, has rucked all day for Hawthorn. Mellington over the top. And Simpson is one of the up-and-coming stars for North Melbourne. The big left footer again. Ooh, he kicked one similar to that. It went right through the middle. Beginning of the fourth term, so he has another behind to his name. One goal, two for Adam Simpson. So the Hawks see another defeat after coming off defeats in previous weeks. Well, Sydney last week, and then Brisbane, Frio, St Kilda, Richmond. They haven't won one since round 14 against Port Adelaide at Waverley. So disappointing times for the Hawthorn side in this finish of the 1997 season. As Stevens to Bell, the 1-2, back again. Racking up the possessions, Anthony Stevens. Quiet second term, but been again one of North Melbourne's best. And leading their possessions. And Harford, who's been under the hammer all day. Same with Scott. His Hawthorn's best player, Mark Graham, hasn't done a thing wrong. But puts his teammate, Daniel Harford, under pressure. And he's calling for Graham. Kick it long. We're messing around with it too much. So it'll be another throw-in. Left half forward for North Melbourne. 35 metres around from their goal. So the Hawks under the hammer. Mellington in front of Salmon. Good work from big Paul Salmon. Handball hooks it over the top only to find Stevens. So really not great vision from the big fish. Stevens handball to Laidley. Has time to set it up beautifully. Archer. Ho-hoo! The big diving marker just spilled out of the big arms. Now the running ball out of the half-back line. Dixon. Off to Chick. Hawthorn down the corridor. This is better for the Hawks, but he goes wide to the leading Crawford. He's wrapped up by Johnny Blakey. Blakey's just taken Shane Crawford apart today. Now Schwoss trying to control. control the ball. He does it well. Dixon's tackle is good, but the ball is spilt free now to Martin Pike. Kicks inside 50. Running mark dropped by Scott. Now Simpson a chance. Arch up wide to Stevens. He can steady. Number 38 for North Melbourne and makes no mistake. Their 10th.
We'd be happy to kick that because he missed an absolute sitter just before half time.
Well, Pete, your prediction, 10 goals will win it, you call it, and I think you might be right.
Might be too far wrong, would it?
Yep.
10-21, though, I suppose North have given me a little bit of a help.
Certainly. With 2.5 minutes remaining, so there's a big chance that that could be the winning score, but it's a good effort from North Melbourne, and a lot of these young kids. Chandler here has spent a lot of time on the bench. Arch has been quiet, but Stevens, limited opportunities, but doesn't let the side down.
Danny Stevens' first goal. He's kicked 1-1. The one was the shocker before half-time. So the Roos just about double Hawthorn's score. 81 plays 42 late in the final quarter. Finally get an effective touch. Martin to half-forward. Bounces it to Anderson. Chandler. Good tackle by Crummell. Ball jarred free from Scholl. Salmon trying to pick it up. On to Hassel. Hassel chips it in short, out to Lord. He'll get past Pike, okay. Woods provides the shepherd. Crawford with his shadow. Johnny Blakey. Lord's try said he's taken him apart today. Crawford has had little influence on the match. 3 kicks, 7 hand passes. You would expect more from a player of his ilk. That's probably taking something away from John Blakey, though. Just the same, has been excellent. Carey over the top of his opponent. It's Holland. Now Rat tried to tap it forward. Comes out the side. Holland. A quick kick. It bounces. It bounces through for only one behind, though. By Nick Holland.
His third behind, Pete. Yeah, well, and Nick returned to the side last week after spending some 5 weeks out with a knee. 4 goals, 3 was right in there amongst it. But in limited opportunities today, hasn't made much of anything.
Longmire from Blakey at half-back. There's no one on centre wing. The ball might even stop before they get there. Scholl beats Crummell to it, and that's out of bounds. On centre wing, we have 1.5 minutes to go.
So North Melbourne have continued on since the middle part of the second quarter and really taking control of the game. Denis Pagan looking on. He'd be quite pleased with the outcomes here. This has been a very solid workout in difficult, wet and slippery conditions. And so it's really put the players in good stead, I think, for their final round encounter next week against Collingwood back here at the MCG.
Yeah, that game next Sunday, as we see the Hawthorn Brains Trust, Ken Judge chewing the gum, Peter Schwab, premiership player with the headset.
You've got some tough decisions to make over the summer period.
Certainly.
On a few players.
But I think a lot of clubs do, Terry, as we've seen.
Correct.
Throughout the year, the Collingwoods and the Essendons and these types of clubs have been under the hammer. As Brett Allison already has 4 goals to his name, trundles one into the forward line. Graham, under the hammer, Anderson. It's all Hawthorn, though, with Hassel over the top to Graham now. Johnny Platton has had plenty of the ball. He's been busy and hasn't stopped trying. Kepler, with the big left foot, puts it on the chest of Stevie Lawrence, another part-time player who's got the splinters in the old tail today. His kick up towards half-forward. Robren in the front of the pack. Holland starting to get a few kicks, but albeit too late. Carey has actually taken him apart as well. There's now Daniel Harford on the left foot. Hooks it around, but not good enough. And out of bounds on the full. So nothing going right for the Hawthorn side.
He's worked at his task, I think, Harford all day. Simpson's really got off him for too many times.
Yeah.
So they've played a little bit wide of each other since that early part of the game. Both players racking up possessions.
Oh, the horse has kicked straight into the man on the mark, and that's out of bounds.
He's looking a little bit weary just at the moment, Johnny, isn't he? It's been a big day for him.
Especially in these conditions, Terry, playing in the ruck where you're always constantly jumping and bustling in packs.
Well, can the Hawks get one to add a little bit of respectability to their score? Not from that thrust forward. So without Corey McKernan, North Melbourne go to chalk up a win, and that's somewhat of a rarity in recent times. Mellington over the top, doing the sensible thing. Harford, Stevens comes at him.
Ball's gone right across the face of goal and out of bounds on the other side. So another throw in. A day that will be remembered for the rain as much as anything else, I think. Holland in front. Tries to take it. Kick it over his shoulder. Not successful. There's the siren to put the Hawks out of their misery. And North Melbourne have got the 4 points, and I think they'd be more than happy with that. Probably could have won by more. Certainly the scoreboard would indicate that. The final tally, North Melbourne 10-21, 81, defeating Hawthorn 6-7, 43 in the penultimate round of 97 at the MCG.
Thank you.
A level here with Brett Allison, North Melbourne in front right throughout, winning the game. Yep. Can we take it?
Can you hear me? Can you hear David?
Yes, David. Thank you. I missed that last bit, Marty. So can we take it? Yep, we go with it.
I'm keen.
Keen, want to get this done. He's doing a favour. This is a favour. I don't want to catch him. Don't run out of him.
No, you're right.
No.
What am I
going
to run?
Are your piece turned up?
You're right there.
Bit technical, all this stuff. That's what I haven't got the hang of yet, Marty. All this technical shit. I can't. Okay. Brett, congratulations on your own individual efforts today. The slippery ball, you didn't mind roving that contest?
Yeah, good day for a little bloke like myself, I suppose. The ball's going to be on the ground a bit, and luckily it fell my way a few times today.
Last week's hiccup, how much did that set the preparations back for the finals?
Well, yeah, it was a bit of a kick in the teeth, I suppose, and we just had to steel ourselves for this week and come out hard against Hawthorn. We knew they were going to be, they'd be a big chance to knock us off. So, we really knew we just had to win today, and then now we can set our sights to next week, and hopefully, a few results might go our way, and we might be able to get away with what happened last week.
And you're looking forward to Anthony Rock and Corey McKernan. How far off are they, you think?
Not too sure on either. They both, Corey, I did notice, was running the other day, so hopefully he's not too far away. Rocky, haven't seen him out on the track, so I'm not really sure how far. Probably not before the finals, though.
Brett, back-to-back is a big call, but is it possible for this year's side?
Look, I think it's possible. Anyone who can make the eight's got a big chance this year. It's that even. It's not funny. It's who's up on the day, who's got their best team on the ground on the day, and, it's not beyond us.
Well, good luck to you, and I hope you do well.
Thanks very much, Joe.
You're a marvel, son. Thanks, Brett. Oh, yeah. Hey.
Yep, go.
Yes, Marty. Where would I find the
okay
to this little?
No, Terry went to grab somebody and he came back with that. Okay. David, do you want Terry to grab somebody else?
Yeah. very